Hey everyone, welcome back to Tech Talk. I'm Juliet Beauchamp. I'm here with Network World senior writer John Gold, and we are going to be talking about IoT and blockchain, two really buzzy words, but do they really have any purpose together? Stick around. All right, John, thank you so much for coming in.
Thanks for having me back.
Always appreciate it. So you cover IoT pretty extensively.
Yes.
And there's obviously tons of use cases for IoT for consumers and, of course, in the enterprise. But something that is sort of new information to me is how blockchain and IoT can come together. There's sort of these two buzzy words, but do they really serve any purpose in conjunction?
I think they do. You know, based on some of the reporting I've done lately, I think part of the reason that people are eager to talk about it is that, as you mentioned, these are a couple of buzzy words and people are eager to get them into the same sentence. But there are definitely use cases out there, particularly as one source explained it to me really nicely, as in cases where, you know, two parties don't quite trust each other, but they would like to. So, you know, largely anything sort of transactional or, you know, working on that kind of model, I guess, is where blockchain is pretty applicable.
Yeah. And so can you give me an example of what would be an example of sort of this transactional application of IoT?
Yeah. Well, one example that was given to me was, say you had like a system for, you know, tracking like really like fine foodstuffs, like, you know, farm to fork, basically tracking of like, you know, I don't know, I guess expensive, you know, well-bred meat or something, you know, so it, you know, broadly there'd be, you know, asset tracking at every level of that process, you know, coming from, and you'd have the secure database thanks to, you know, blockchain technology where it, you know, says that, you know, this has been, you know, this product has been in this location for X number of days, it's been refrigerated at Y temperature, you know, it, and, you know, just there'd be sort of this immutable record, you know, the idea is throughout the process. So, you know, just, I guess, cutting out, you know, wholesalers, middlemen along the way.
Sure, and using IoT sensors to, for example, say, you know, this is the temperature that it was stored at.
Right. Or exactly.
That's really interesting. It's something, I mean, you do hear really frequently references to IoT, and it's obviously huge. I don't have to tell you this. But it is really interesting to sort of see ways to unite these two technologies. And it's not just, and it's really not all talk, just saying, well, you know what, blockchain would be a great solution for this.
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it is a really interesting idea, just, again, based on sort of, you know, adding this layer of sort of trust and validation over, you know, any kind of transactional system. You know, it adds that kind of security without the need for, you know, other kinds of, you know, expensive specialized systems. So,
and you make a really good point. We're going to link John's article in the description so you can read more about this. But you make a really good point in your article that if, because blockchain is sort of this immutable record, if there's any sort of break or pause, that could sort of raise concern to anyone.
Yeah, I mean, that was sort of revealed to me in the context of, you know, I learned about this basically just, you know, in the context of these examples that was provided, because it's sort of a hard technology to grasp on an intuitive level sometimes.
Yeah.
But yeah, that was in the context of, there's one company I spoke to that's making sort of a product that, you know, it's meant sort of for the used car market.
Mm-hmm.
So what it would do is it would plug into like a diagnostic port on your car, and, you know, just kind of keep, you know, a maintenance record. You know, it would be able to tell you whether, you know, like the airbags have been deployed, whether the car's ever been flooded. And yeah, and if it was removed, there would be, you know, this big blank space in the data where, you know, it says, well, hang on, this wasn't being monitored. What's going on there? Yeah.
Right, it can raise concern or at least prompt someone to ask more questions.
Exactly, because ideally it's in this blockchain system, it's not, you can't tamper with it, so it's not like, you know, the bad old days of used cars where somebody could just, like, roll back the odometer with a drill
right,
or something.
Right. And it's because that also adds that extra layer of security. First of all, just because it's in the blockchain, there's an extra layer of security, but mm-hmm. also as a potential buyer, whether I'm a used car seller or just an actual buyer, it's that extra sense of just personal security, knowing that this has not been tampered with. Same goes for your farm to sort of table food mm-hmm. example. which is really great. But I think it's also important while we're going on and on about how there's potential use cases for IoT and blockchain, it's also important to say, you know, you don't need to be going applying blockchain to every single IoT device.
Yeah, there are definitely, you know, exceptions. There are all these, there are cool use cases out there. And, you know, they're not 100%, you know, this sort of transactional model where it's, you know, about some kind of, you know, exchange of products or services. But, you know, it is largely, that's where it works best, definitely. Mm-hmm. And, you know, people might get, you know, because as we've talked about, these are, you know, very exciting sort of techie terms that everyone likes to use these days. But, yeah, it's definitely not the right, you know, technology for every use case. You know, it's a database. It doesn't, you know, it's just not applicable to everything you're using the IoT for.
Absolutely. So there's no need to go out and employ blockchain and IoT combinations in your you don't need to rush into it.
No, definitely not.
And because this is sort of, it seems to me, please correct me if I'm wrong, that these are sort of newer use cases, that this is really coming into its own now.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, blockchain itself isn't, you know, brand new, but the idea of, you know, mixing it into, you know, some sort of IoT deployment is definitely pretty new. And, you know, not, you know, my impression at any rate is that it's not super well understood yet, you know, the way the two technologies sort of interact. And, you know, based on how, you know, nebulous and widespread IoT is, you know, that's not really a surprise, I guess.
And because it's new, how would you recommend enterprises employing it where there is sort of this transactional application?
Yeah, it would definitely be focused on that kind of use case. You know, at this point, you know, unless you're a really, really big company who can, you know, afford to hire blockchain programmers, and I'm told that they cost a lot of money. But it's definitely something that, you know, mostly you're going to want to work with a vendor on. You know, you're going to need, you know, sort of like a, like, you know, most of the companies that are offering this sort of thing, you know, some of them are like SAP. You know, they're going to have a lot of in-house expertise and that you'll probably need to get that kind of thing up and running.
Sure. And it's, you know, relying on a vendor for this sort of thing is, yeah, it makes sense.
Right.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming in, John. It's really interesting to see how IoT and blockchain can be applied in the enterprise. It's exciting. Do you think we'll hear more soon?
Oh, I don't know if you'll hear a lot, you know, more, you know, brand new information soon, but yeah, definitely down the line, there'll be more use cases, more applications coming out of the woodwork.
And in any case, we'll be sure to keep everyone in the loop if there are more use cases.
Absolutely.
We'll bring John back on.
Well, thanks.
Yeah, thank you so much, John. And thank you so much for watching this episode of Tech Talk. If you liked this video, be sure to like it and subscribe to our channel. And we will be linking John's story in the description. So if you want to learn even more about this, John's story really expands nicely on it. Be sure to check that out. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.